follow through on wide range days. At least 3 to 4 times in a month, the markets or the index gives us trend days. A trend day is a day in which the markets open at one end of the day's range and close at the other end. For example, this is a 5-minute chart for Nifty futures. We are going to use this chart to explain what a trend day means. Now, a trend day opens at one point, one end of the day's range and closes at the other point, at the other end. Let's look at this. The market opened here. This is the opening price for the day. Throughout the day, the market moved in one direction, which is up in this case, and closed here. So if we look at the day's range, the open was here and the close was at the opposite side of the range. That means the market had a trend in one direction throughout the day. This is what a trend day means. In this case, we are looking at an uptrend day. We could also have a downtrend day where the markets open at the highs. Throughout the day, they come down and close at the lows. In any case, it would be a trend day. So a trend day is a tradable day for intraday traders, for swing traders, for everyone. You just have to be on the right side of the trend day. Now a trend day can be a narrow range day or a normal day or a wide range day. A narrow range day means the markets opened and gave us a trend day, but the day's range was narrow. So as the definition itself tells us, if you have a narrow range day, then the intraday gains at least were limited, but that's what the market gave us and we have to take it. A normal day would mean a day in which the daily range was the average of the prevailing range. That's the most likely scenario for a trend day, when the markets opened at one end, closed at the other end, giving us a tradable rally or a tradable decline if it's a trend day on the downside. And the range is an average day's range. That's the best case expectation. But sometimes we have a trend day which is a wide range day. That means that the day's range is significantly higher than the range of the average day. So first, if you are positioned on the right side of the market, a trend day gives you money because you open at one end, you buy there, and the market closes at the other end of the range and you sell at the top. And that's a profitable trade. Now, adding more juice to this trade is if it is a wide range day. If the daily range for the Nifty is 80 points, the difference between the high and the low, a wide range day could maybe give us 140 points. That means the markets opened at the low end of the day, you went long, and the markets closed 140 points higher, essentially giving you a profitable trade that gave a gain of 140 days versus the 70 or 80 points that you would have normally accepted. So we have a trend day, which is a day in one direction, and a wide range trend day, which is a day where a trend exists and a big expansion takes place during the day. After a wide range trend day, which is what we are discussing now, the markets will usually pause. It is very unlikely that we will have back-to-back 2 trend days, and even more unlikely that we will have back-to-back 2 wide-range trend days. That happens only in the run-up phase of a market, and usually the run-up phases are very few. So once you have a trend, wide-range trend day, which is possible maybe even once every month, the next day is a pause. So the trader should be prepared to buy, assuming that the trend is on the upside, the trader should be prepared to buy only on significant dips, because the markets could become choppy the next day. A wide range trend day is unlikely to see follow through the next day, which means traders should be positioning themselves to trade the mean reversion method rather than look at a trend.